All right. Hi, welcome back to another freaking shopping haul. I'm gonna continue doing these for years until my addiction goes away, which I don't think it ever will, as long as I keep making money somehow. I just have to say that I think I am done with my demonia's collection or whatever it is for right now, because I need to stop. Because I have a video planned for after this one, and by the time I upload this one, and by the time the next week rolls around, which hopefully I will be posting in a week, the shoes and like everything that I ordered will be here. So yes, I have two videos planned after this one. Look at me being ahead, finally. Yeah, okay, let's go. So the first item is a taekwondo sweater, zip-up sweater that I got from a thrift store in Brooklyn, which I can't remember the name of it, but it's a famous thrift store in Brooklyn, and it's like huge. It'll come back to me at some point. And eventually, going to take rubbing alcohol and take off this. Although I think it looks pretty cool, but I don't really want a taekwondo hoodie. I think the logo also looks cool. Now the next item, which I don't think I've ever showed you guys before, but I bought it a while ago, but the next item is this Skele Animals hoodie that I bought, and I bought it from Amazon, and it may not be real, but it has the tag and everything attached to it, and it said dead stock and all that stuff. The bat wings, the little skeleton animals thing on the front there, and the little bat ears. The next thing that I bought was this Apex hoodie, and this is also from the thrift store in Brooklyn. Yes, it is very big, but I love the oversized look, and this goes to like mid-thigh on me when I wear this, so it looks perfect with my outfits, even though it's covering up the outfit, but you can still see the shoes, so it's fine. I'm usually scared to buy things with pockets in them at thrift stores because not all thrift stores clean their stuff, so like I'm always scared to just dig in and find something nasty. But I didn't, and I love this jacket. The next thing I bought was this sweater, and I bought it from Amazon. It's a Hanes medium men's sweater, and I bought it because you may not know it, but sometimes you really need basic stuff in your wardrobe. Cause like this looks nice with certain skirts, or certain pants, certain shoes, whatever the heck I'm wearing. The next thing that I bought was this sweater. Also, this is from the store as well, which I'm so upset that I cannot remember what it's called. And it's just a regular extra large sweater. It's not Hanes. I don't really know what it is. It's Jerseys. I guess that's the brand. But yeah, it's only like $3. Maybe not even that. I don't remember. But I was searching for a plain sweater because they had a whole bunch of sweaters that had like sports teams and stuff on it. And yeah, I could just do the rubbing alcohol and take it off. But I wasn't about to buy a whole bunch of stuff and have to do that. Finally, after digging, I found this sweater here. And as you guys know, or maybe you don't know, but my favorite colors are black, red, white, blue, and green. So a lot of my wardrobe consists of black, red, white, and blue, but not green. The next items of clothing that we're gonna go over are skirts. Skirts are very essential in my wardrobe. So I bought this schoolgirl skirt, that's what it was called, from Amazon. It's a size small. I'll link all things that I can link in the description. This skirt, everybody was saying to size up, so I sized up, but then it's a bit too big, and I should have gotten an extra small. I love this skirt because it's a bit longer than the skirts that I normally have. Out of all the skirts that I have, this is one of the longest, and it has a lot of bounce to it, so I'm not really used to skirts like this. The next two skirts that I bought were from Cider, which is a store that TikTok was promoting like crazy to me. I wasn't falling for it, but until I saw that they had $12 tennis skirt, pleated skirts, I was like, okay, this is where we're going, because all these other stores are gonna charge like $30. So I got a black one, and I also bought a white one, and I only paid about $25 to get the skirts and get them over here. Amazing. And then the last skirt is another pleated skirt that I got from AliExpress, and it comes with like strings so that you could tie them here. It's also a little bit big, but still fit. I like the skirt mainly because of the lace and then the fact that you can put ties right here. It also reminds me of Trip NYC skirts, which I gotta talk about that. I went on Hot Topic because I was just recently in North Carolina to visit my mom, and I was looking on the Hot Topic website, and they're having like a 30% sale right now on Trip NYC stuff. They had a whole bunch of stuff in stock in North Carolina because every time I search up here that it's always sold out. I didn't go crazy because it's still expensive even if it was percentage at all, but I got something that you're gonna see in a week, another week or two. Moving on to the accessories that I got. So I'm just gonna go over jewelry because I've toned down with buying jewelry, and I'm very proud of myself for doing that. So the first piece of jewelry that I'm gonna go over is IGIRL candy apple necklace. It was very hard to get this. The store kept crashing. Very satisfied with my purchase. I'm really into layering necklaces, so this is a perfect layer because it's a little bit longer than the IGIRL necklace, so it can go like a bit below that. Well, at least that's how it is for me on my, I don't know about everybody else's neck. So the next IGIRL necklace that I got was this gully chain, which was a freaking rush to buy, very hard to buy. I love this necklace. The only thing about it is that whenever I wear it, it has to be worn alone or with like a choker or with something a bit longer than it. Because it's so chunky, I feel like I can't really layer it with other necklaces. So I tend to wear this necklace alone and when I have like on a V-neck shirt. So the next items are bags. And so the first bag is this crossbody bag that I bought from the thrift store in Brooklyn. This one, it's a bit more fancier than I usually go for, which some people would still not think it's fancy, but I feel like it looks fancy for my taste. I only had a plain black bag, which wasn't so like work friendly, which I don't work, but like, yeah. So I bought this bag because I wanted more black bags because I wear a lot of black, even though my bags are usually things that add color to my wardrobe, but it's fine. So and once again, I was very scared to buy this because you never know what you're gonna find inside of one of these bags because thrift stores don't always go through their stuff. Thankfully, nothing was in it. And then the last bag was this bag that I bought from a Depop seller from Canada. It has a little ghost girl on the front. I've become obsessed with like spooky things. Like I've always liked Nightmare Before Christmas and The Corpse Bride and Coraline, all that stuff. I really love those types of movies. And I'm fine with scary movies. I can watch scary movies and be fine. It's another black and white crossbody bag, but this one's a bit more casual. And it's a brand that is only in Canada, apparently. It's called Fix 8, 100% Canadian. And then the next things we're going over are shoes. And the first pair of shoes that I bought, which, why am I always buying two pairs of shoes at once? Why can't I never buy just one? I don't know, but the first shoe are the Ranger 301s. I wanted to get the short one because I figured I wear the short ones more than the longer ones, but I also want the longer ones, but I don't think I'm gonna do it right now. I love these because, like, look at that chunky toe area. And then I love the way that the heel looks like kind of funky, and I was very excited for these. I was gonna do like a shop with me video, and these are part of that, and the excitement in my bones when I bought these was crazy. Sadly, that footage is nowhere to be found. So yeah. And then the next and last shoe, as well as the last item in this shopping haul, are these Trashville 518s, which also the excitement when I first opened these was on another level. And I forgot that I wore these outside and my hands are all over the bottom, but it doesn't matter. I freaking love these. At first I wanted to get the glossier ones, but then those were sold out. And you know me, I settled. So I settled for the matte ones, which are fine with me. But if the glossy ones come out, then who knows if I'll be buying those. It's like, I don't even know, you know? Some people may say, specifically my mother, they may say that they look very similar to the damned shoes, those ones, but they're not. They're very different, and I don't regret my purchase, and I love the way that they feel on my foot. Yeah. And I bought both of those shoes from Pleaser Shoes. But yeah, thank you for watching, and also thank you for 700 freaking subscribers. I probably said 500 freaking subscribers when that happened. I can't believe there are like people who are actually watching my videos. My Demonia's collection video is at 5,000 views right now, I think. And that is nuts for me because I've been doing this since my sophomore year of high school, and I'm now in my freshman year of college. So it's a bit nuts. And this is just like a little hobby that I have, and it's just you guys watching me open stuff. And yeah, I can't believe you're here and you're watching my videos. And yeah, we have some big plans for the future. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you for subscribing. If you subscribed, like, subscribe, watch more videos. See you in the next video, which hopefully will be a week from this video. Yeah, all right. Peace out. See you later. Bye-bye.